Sleep Studies, your night in the sleep laboratory. A sleep study, also called a polysomnogram, is an overnight study of your sleep, which takes place in a specialized laboratory. It is conducted by a trained technologist and is designed to detect problems with your sleep. The goal of the study is to have a natural night of sleep that is as uncomplicated and comfortable as possible. You may wish to bring along your own pajamas, robe, slippers, and personal hygiene items. Some people like to bring their own pillow. In addition, you might think of packing a snack if you are used to having one before bedtime. When you come to the laboratory, a technologist will greet you and show you the location of the bedroom, bathroom, and control room. The technologist will stay through the night to ensure safety and proper procedures. High-quality tracings will be obtained. There is a TV camera in the room to monitor your sleep, as well as an intercom to communicate with the technologist. It is standard practice to videotape sleep studies in case any unusual activity occurs during testing. When it is time, you will change into your night clothes, and the sleep study technologist will hook up many electrodes. This does not cause pain. The electrodes are metal and shaped like a tiny cup about a quarter inch in diameter. They attach to wires, which go to amplifiers so that electrical signals can be recorded. Because the position of the electrodes is quite important, the technologist will measure your head and mark it for placement. The scalp will be cleaned thoroughly in order to get a good signal. The electrodes will then be attached with either glue or paste. The technologist may scratch the scalp gently to improve the electrical connection. Altogether, about 7 electrodes will be applied to the scalp. Electrodes will also be applied around the eyes to detect eye movement. Recording eye movements helps the technologist determine which stage of sleep you are in. Electrodes are also placed on the chin in order to monitor muscle tone. Next, a snoring sensor, which is a tiny microphone, will be placed on the neck. Sensors will be taped near the nose and mouth to detect airflow when you are breathing. Belts will be placed around your chest and abdomen to detect the movement associated with breathing. A sensor that shines a bright red light will be placed on your finger. This sensor monitors the amount of oxygen in your blood. EKG sensors will be placed on your chest to monitor your heart rate. Finally, some electrodes will be attached to the muscles on your legs and sometimes your arms to monitor muscle tone. You may wonder if you will be able to sleep with all these wires attached. Most people sleep quite well. You can be easily unhooked whenever you want to move around and go to the bathroom. You should be able to sleep in any position that is comfortable for you. There are occasions when the electrodes may become loose and the technologist will have to come in and reapply them. Just before turning the lights out, the technologist will have you go through a series of tasks, including moving and shutting your eyes, clenching your teeth, and so on. This is so the technologist can be sure that she is picking up all the appropriate signals. If the reason for doing the sleep study is to determine if a person has obstructive sleep apnea, and sleep apnea occurs in the first half of the night, the technologist may start treatment with continuous positive airway pressure, or CPAP. CPAP involves wearing a mask over the nose. The technologist will adjust the pressure so that the airway stays open. It may take a little getting used to, but it should not be uncomfortable. After the study is complete, you will be awakened and the electrodes will be removed. This takes about 10 minutes. There may be some glue or paste in your hair, which will need to be washed out the next time you shower. The work is not over for the technologist. The record needs to be analyzed and scored. This is usually done several days after the test is completed. After the record is scored, a report will be generated, and your healthcare provider will review it in detail. In most cases, a follow-up visit is indicated to discuss the results of the test procedures and to generate a treatment plan. Things to remember. Do not be concerned about having a sleep study. Most people sleep quite well and are comfortable throughout the night. Bring comfortable items from home, such as your own pajamas, robe, slippers, and personal hygiene items. What we have learned. A sleep study is used to detect problems during sleep. True or false? The answer is true. Electrodes are placed on your body to take various measurements during sleep. True or false? The answer is true. You will probably have trouble sleeping during a sleep study. True or false? The answer is false.